Hoglander again. He's going to draw a penalty. Gives the puck up immediately. And now Forbort's after him again. Still mad about that headshot that he purported was a headshot. And it's a dogpile in the Winnipeg zone.
Well, and now you talked about maybe bad feelings for Sunday. Forbort did not like that hit. And you saw the cross checks. The referees decided to ignore both.
Vertanen's got the gloves off
with Pionk. Here comes Adam Lowry over.
Now, does Forbort risk an instigator here late in the game?
Yes.
Which could cost his coach. Myers is underneath Appleton and still trying to get at Derek Forbort, who went after the Canuck rookie, who a couple of shifts ago hit Forbort with a check that he didn't like, came back with a series of cross checks, and now with a 2-0 lead, trying for a little extra frontier justice.
Well, we saw the referee's arm up. There was going to be a penalty first. Derek Forbort, 6'4", 220. So we can see the size mismatch. It was Hoglander, 5'9", 185. And there's Forbort going after Hoglander. There's no doubt who was the instigator in that, but will the referees call an instigator penalty? You can bet the Canucks will remember this, though.
48 hours from now?
Yes. And just the size discrepancy.
So late in the game that, well, there'll be a power play, so they'll have to put somebody in the box, you would think. But the discussion now about how they're going to dole this out with 41.3 seconds left in a 2-0 game.
They've upped it to 42.
Well, while they keep talking, maybe they could just keep upping the time and see if nobody notices.
Yes. I can understand Derek Forbort being upset. Didn't like the hit.
Was the three cross checks not enough? For
yes.
They let him get away with the three cross checks.
And you can see Nils Hoglander is all right after being on the bottom of that dog pile. Forbort didn't throw a whole bunch of punches, but he grabbed a hold of Hoglander right away. Brad Myers is explaining things.
Vertanen's still there. He dropped the gloves of Neil Pion. And now Newell Brown, Travis Green getting the explanation from Steve Barton, the linesman. So maybe not an official explanation, but just an idea of what's going on.
Old-time hockey pile up.
I guess because everybody...
Are they going to go 4-on-4 here?
Oh, I doubt it.
Sure looked like Brad Myers had the 4-on-4 sign up.
I thought for sure because the initial penalty was going Jets way, and the Canucks do have, well, they did have, we'll just wait until they drop the puck.
Yes.
But it looks like the faceoff will be outside the line, and I assume that's because everybody got into the melee. Demko's coming back in goal. And there seems to be some confusion about how many skaters should be out there. And now Demko's headed off again. Or no, he started to head off. He'll stop at the hash marks. JT Miller's lined up way out to the left.
And it is 4-on-4. Riddle me that, Batman.
Demko gets to the bench to make it 5-on-4. And here's Besser shooting. Diving was Beaulieu to get a piece of that and deflect the puck over the glass. Forbort got...